Hey guys, I hope all of you are doing good and staying safe. Today I have one of the burning topics in the world of payment, tokenization. Many of us enroll a card in a wallet-based application like Apple Pay or Samsung Pay and just start using our mobile phones as tap and pay on a point of sale terminal. But what happens in the back of the system when you tokenize your card and do a transaction? This is something we are going to cover in the next one or two sessions. So let's get started and see what is tokenization. You are watching my YouTube channel, Card and Payment Experts by Ramesh Chuk. Please subscribe and click on the bell icon to receive the notifications for all my upcoming videos. Thank you. Before we get into some more details about tokenization, let's try to understand why do we need it and what is tokenization. Think of it two different ways. You are entering your card details on an e-commerce website or a mobile application. And the second scenario is maybe you are trying to use your plastic card information or a plastic card on a point of sale terminal or an ATM terminal. At that point of time, you may have a fear of losing your card details. Maybe you have a risk of someone recording your sensitive information and trying to clone your card, which can be further used for a fraud transaction, right? So what if we come up with something which is very secure and we replace your plastic card with your mobile phone itself? What it means? We create a digital number of your card. And you don't need to carry your plastic card anymore. All you need to do is just use your mobile device to make a payment. And even if you lose your mobile phone, no need to worry about it, because you can still block the digital number, the token information that you might have created on a wallet-based application, Samsung Pay or Apple Pay, that you can still block. And the actual card number is still safe because you're not carrying it with you. And in any case, we generally keep our mobile phone or any other mobile application very secure with a static password or a biometric fingerprint or a face detection, right? So we ourselves are providing one level of security. And on top of it, when you create a digital token of your card number, it means you are making yourself very secure and minimizing the exposure of your sensitive information to those online applications, point of sale, or ATM terminals. What is tokenization? In payment terminology, the card number is a sensitive information. And tokenization is the process to replace this card number, the sensitive information, with a digital surrogate value, which is non-sensitive in nature, which is called a token. Or in other words, in a simple words, I can say token is a digital representation of a card number. And de-tokenization is a reverse process of redeeming a token. In easy terms, when you enroll your card in Apple Pay or Samsung Pay or any other wallet-based application, that time what happens? We basically use the application to create a token, so that the actual card number becomes invisible. And when we perform a transaction using our mobile phone, that time the de-tokenization happens, but only at the payment scheme or TSP level. TSP means token service provider. But I will cover it in more details in the next few minutes. Now, let's try to understand how many participants are there to ensure end-to-end execution of digitization or tokenization, and also the token-based payment transactions. The first one is wallet provider or the mobile application provider, where customer enters the card details and get a token created with the help of a digital wallet-based application. So basically, this is the application where we as a customer save our card data and secure it with the PIN or password. Second one is token requester. This could be a separate system or an application, a tool, or a software who collects the card data from wallet application and sends it to a TSP. TSP is token service provider. In some cases, wallet provider and token requester both are same entity. As far as I understand, Samsung Pay, Apple Pay, both can be considered as wallet provider as well as token requester. But in some cases, for example, a bank or a financial institute or any issuer processor, they may have their own wallet-based digital application. And for the token requester, they are dependent on some third-party solutions, which can be an API or SDK-based integration. So the idea is to understand that the first one in the row is mobile application, and the second one is a token requester. And finally, the third one is a token service provider. So what is TSP here? In very easy language, TSP is payment scheme or interchange or a payment associations who verifies the card holder data with the help of issuer. And then provision a token, finally activate a token and maintain it in a secure database. And the last one is acquirer and issuer. I think do not require any detailed explanation here because it has been covered multiple times in my previous videos. So you can go through some of my old videos to understand the role of issuer and acquirer in general. However, in today's session, we will cover the role of issuer from token provisioning and customer verification point of view. Now let's take an example to understand the use of tokenization and the benefit of using a surrogate value or a token data instead of a card number at the merchant end. Let's assume a customer is visiting a merchant with a piece of plastic which has card number printed on. So ultimately the customer is going to share his clear card number with the merchant. And this is the risk I was talking about earlier, exposing your sensitive information to the merchant. Do you really feel comfortable giving it to someone whom you really don't know? What if you have a choice of replacing this card number with a different value and a surrogate value which has absolutely no relation to the original card? So in this case, rather than providing the clear card to the merchant, what a customer can share is a new digital number, which is a token. And this value is mapped to the original card number in a token service provider database, which is a secure database. In the diagram, this value 4111, this is the clear card number. And with the help of tokenization, we created another value, 5678123412. So now what happens when a customer is going to perform a transaction at a merchant level? Let's assume that on a point of sale terminal. So in this kind of scenario, rather than providing this value, now this value will be given to the merchant. Merchant will supply it to the acquirer and acquirer will forward it to the TSP or a payment system. So now this mapping between these two card numbers, basically one is the clear, the actual original card number, other one is just a digital token of the card. The mapping between these two is already stored in the TSP, right? In a token service provider. So what token service provider is going to do in this case, they are going to extract the original card number of the card holder, which is this value, and they are going to push it to the issuer. So what issuer is eventually going to receive? They are going to receive only the clear card information, but there are certain data elements where this token information would also be forwarded to the issuer for a record purpose or for logging purpose. The key point over here is, between merchant, acquirer, and TSP, the clear value of the card does not exist. Although TSP has that, but at the transaction level, when merchant is accepting the payment, that time the clear card number is not there. Then it forwards the request to acquirer, still it's not there. And then finally it reaches to the TSP. So TSP is the one who actually, you know, search for the original card number, extract it, and finally send it to the issuer. By now, I hope you are able to understand the use of tokenization at a very high level, but let's go a little deeper into it in the next slide. Broadly, the tokenization process can be divided into three major areas. Number one is pre-digitization. Second one is authorization, payment transaction, and third one is token lifecycle. Probably in today's session, we would be able to cover only the pre-digitization step in detail. Authorization, high level, we just now covered, but for a detailed version of authorization, token-based transaction, I would better, you know, create a separate video. We will quickly start the pre-digitization steps. Pre-digitization itself is divided into three different steps: token provisioning, cardholder authentication, which is second factor authentication, and token activation. And the final one is tokenization completion. So now we will go a little more deeper and try to understand how these three steps are done when you try to, you know, enroll your card in any wallet-based application. Before I start explaining about pre-digitization steps in more details, I would suggest you to assume that you open a mobile application, a wallet-based application, and you also have a credit card, which is issued by any issuing bank. And now you are trying to register your card in the wallet-based application for a tokenization. We will use this diagram to understand all the stepwise execution one by one. At step number one, cardholder basically enters the card information in the wallet-based application. So this is step number one. Just follow me in the diagram. You would clearly understand. I'll try to make it very easy, very simple for you guys. So you open the mobile application, you are providing the card details, either you are manually entering it or maybe you are scanning it with the help of camera. Okay, that's how you provided your card data to the wallet-based application. This card information will be collected by the TR. TR is the token requester. I explained you just a few minutes ago what is token requester. So in this diagram, I'm assuming that wallet-based application and token requester both are separate. It can be one entity as well, as I told you earlier, in case of Samsung Pay or Apple Pay. So now what happens is, like, the information is collected by WP, and WP would forward it to TR, and TR would forward it to TSP. So TSP is the token service provider. So this is step number two, where the information, the card information, which has been collected by the wallet provider, it has been forwarded to the token service provider. At step number two, TSP has received a token request from a wallet provider or a token requester. So TSP would understand the card BIN number and all the details they would receive from the token requester. So based on the card BIN, TSP is going to identify the issuing bank. First of all, so once they identify the issuing bank or the issuing processor, they're going to send the request to verify the card availability in the issuing system. So this is step number three. So issuer system, they will check some basic account status related checks, and then there are some other digitization risk analysis. They would perform all those basic checks and would send a success or a maybe a decline response back to the TSP. But please keep in mind, this step is optional step. It is not mandated by the token service provider for any issuer to execute the availability check, because there is a next step, which is a token eligibility request, that makes more sense for an issuer to verify the card data, card holder data, expiry date, CVV2 value, card availability in the system. At step number four, which is token eligibility request, issuer will verify the card information in the system and they will send a response back to TSP. I would like to give a small pause over here just to repeat and revise the step that we just now followed here. A cardholder provided the card information on a mobile-based application, which has been collected by TR and sent to token service provider. Now, token service provider is doing two steps. Number one is the availability, other one is the token eligibility request, out of which the availability one is the optional. So token eligibility request basically verifies the card information in the system, which is done by an issuing processor or issuing bank, and as a response is sent back to TSP. So at this level, if a TSP is going to receive a good response from the issuer side, that means this is a go ahead for a TSP to create a token. to provision a token against the actual or the original card number. When TSP receives a successful response for step number 4, this is when they are going to create a token. They are going to provision a token. And once this token is provisioned, this is created, this information will be sent back to the cardholder mobile application because the token has been successfully issued. So it has to go back to the application from where it was originated. So at step number 5, you can see the token provisioning response is sent back to the cardholder wallet-based application. The first step of pre-digitization, which is token provisioning, is done till point number 5. The next step is cardholder authentication and token activation, which is step number 6. I'm going to cover only one method of cardholder authentication, which is OTP based, but there are other methods as well, which are provided by TSP, which are basically allowed by TSP, and any issuing bank or issuing processor, they can use their own mobile application also to authenticate any cardholder. But let's only cover one of the way, which is OTP based. And this OTP is basically generated by the token service provider only. So how it is done? So after the token provisioning, the TSP is going to attempt the cardholder authentication. This step is also called as IDNP, and they generate one-time password. So this OTP will be first of all delivered to the issuer at step number 6. You can see that. And then at step number 7, issuing bank will get it delivered to the card. So once cardholder receive it, at step number 8, you can see the cardholder, obviously, after receiving the OTP, they will enter it on the wallet-based application. From the mobile application, token requester will collect it and they will forward it to the TSP bank. Okay, so now what TSP is going to do, again, because this OTP was generated by TSP itself, so they will try to match it. If the value matches, obviously, if it is okay to go, then finally they will activate the token. So you can see at step number 9, the OTP is basically sent to TSP. And at step number 10, they are going to verify it. If it matches, at step number 11, they are going to activate the token information. So two steps are done. Number one is the token provisioning, and second one is token activation is also done after the cardholder authentication. Now, what is the last step? Like, once this token is activated, this information has to be communicated to the issuing bank or issuing processor, as well as to the cardholder wallet application. So at step number 12 and 13, you can see this information will be supplied back to the issuer, also to the cardholder wallet application. At step number 13, a cardholder would be notified about the completion of the tokenization, and he or she should also be notified that the mobile application is now ready to be used on a point of sale terminal, ATM terminal, or maybe in-app transaction processing. Let's take a quick recap of all the pre-digitization steps. From point number 1 to 5, the token provisioning is done, where the card verifications are basically performed by the issuer bank, card availability, expiry date, CVV2, and finally the token is provisioned. From step number 6 until 11, the cardholder authentication with the help of OTP is done, and then finally the token is activated. So what eventually token activation means, in TSP system, token service provider, token information will be mapped against the original card information, and this will be securely stored in the TSP database. So this is step number 6 to 11. And then finally, on step number 12 and 13, the issuing bank would be notified about this successful completion of the tokenization. Thank you so much for watching the video. I'm going to add 2 questions on altekeys.com. You can post your answers here. or you can also add your comments on my YouTube channel. On alltechies.com, there is an option for the feedback also. So kindly feel free to provide any kind of feedback that you may have. Thank you once again. Stay home, stay safe. Bye-bye.